It was a very important decision. We're very well crafted, and I think it will go a long way toward bringing our country together, which our country needs. And they worked long, they worked hard, and frankly, they worked very quickly on something that will be spoken about 100 years from now and 200 years from now. Extremely important.
In the midst of various legal challenges, a big court win for Donald Trump, the former United States president can contest the Republican presidential primary in Colorado after a unanimous decision from the U.S. Supreme Court. Trump had been disqualified by Colorado's Supreme Court from their primary ballot for his role in inciting the January 6, 2021 riots in Washington. He was also struck off the ballot in Maine and Illinois. Section 3 of the 14th Amendment to the US Constitution says anyone who has engaged in insurrection cannot hold federal office. But now the US Supreme Court says only Congress and not states can enforce that.
We cannot have some random state bureaucrat decide, because they have an animus against Donald Trump, that the rest of the country cannot put him in office as president if they so choose.
The decision has a bearing on Colorado and every other state. In a polarized country, it was a stunning 9-0 ruling from the court's justices. The Supreme Court also avoided making a judgment itself on Trump's actions.
Essentially, you cannot take somebody out of a race because an opponent would like to have it that way. You cannot take somebody out of a race. The voters can take the person out of the race very quickly, but a court shouldn't be doing that, and the Supreme Court saw that.
The timing of the judgments was crucial. It came a day before Colorado and Maine will be part of 15 states in the Republican primaries Super Tuesday. More than a third of the 2,429 Republican delegates will be decided on Super Tuesday.
Well, first, let's see what happens on Super Tuesday. I don't like to look at what-ifs or hypotheticals. I think we always have to live in the moment. They didn't think we'd make it to Iowa, and we came 1% from second. They said we were going to be 30 points down in New Hampshire. We got 43%. They didn't think that it would be between me and Trump in the end, and it is.
Trump can all but end the hopes of his last remaining challenger, Nikki Haley. Haley's only primary win so far came recently in the District of Columbia.
The bottom line for Nikki Haley, when you look at this map, 40% is not going to cut it. Unless she's winning states, winning multiple states on Tuesday, she's going to get buried in a delegate avalanche.
It's also Super Tuesday in the Democratic primary, though President Joe Biden faces no serious challenges.